Hello, and today we are with Benito Bengzon Jr., who is the Assistant Secretary International Tourism Promotions for the Department of Tourism of the Philippines. Good morning to you, Mr. Bengzon.
Good morning, Stephen.
Now, Mr. Bengzon, I've got a little bit of a difficult question for you to start with. Things will get easier, I hope, as we go on. The Philippines is one of the most beautiful countries in the world. You have some benefits that some other countries don't have. 99% of your population speaks almost perfect English. You have some of the best beaches in the world. The food is very good. The climate is amazing. And yet, there was a time when Philippine Airlines was the number one airline in the world. There was also a time when the Philippines itself was on par in terms of tourism numbers as some of your local competitors. And yet, in recent times, Philippine Airlines is struggling slightly, and the country in terms of tourism has also struggled, despite other countries having political issues as well. What do you think is the reason behind this?
Well, first of all, thank you for starting off with very encouraging words. You're right, we have everything to offer to our visitors from overseas. I think the main reason is that most of our competitors in the region have grown faster than we have. So if you look at the statistics for inbound arrivals to the Philippines over the last few years, we've actually registered positive growth. It's just that most other regions or most other countries in the region have grown at a faster rate. And this can be attributed to many things, the air access, the room capacities, infrastructure. But these are the elements that we're precisely addressing. We would like to open up our destinations to more international flights. We would like to increase our capacity in terms of hotels and resort rooms. We would like to develop key infrastructure, roads, bridges, airport, and seaport. Now, as regards your question on the airlines, you're right, Philippine Airlines is Asia's first airline. I'm not really an authority to speak about the airline operations, and I would leave it to PAL to explain, but I believe that in the same manner that other destinations have grown at a faster rate, I believe that other airlines also in the region have grown and expanded at a faster rate than our national carrier. But I think what's important is that we are slowly but surely addressing all the concerns that you've mentioned. We will continue to capitalize on our core strengths, warm, hospitable people, English proficient, wide range of cultural, historical attractions, proximity to the major source market. So these are the advantages that we would like to capitalize on. We realize that there are challenges that continue to confront us in terms of lack of air seats, limited infrastructure, lack of accommodations, but these are exactly the issues that we will be addressing in the years to come.
Right. Now, I believe over 2009, you actually experienced a 15.6% growth in 2010.
That's correct? For 2010.
Right. 2010. Now, where are the majority of these increases coming from? Are they from the Asia Pacific region, or are you able, despite PAL not flying to Europe, are you able still to show positive growth on the European markets as well?
The good news is that the growth rate that we experience for 2010 cuts across all markets. So whether you're talking of Europe, North America, Northeast Asia, Southeast Asia, it's all positive. And of course, even Australia, where we grew by about 10% over 2009. So if we're able to sustain a growth rate of about 10 to 12%, per year over the next 5 years, then we will achieve our target of doubling our arrivals by 2016.
Right. And at the moment, I believe again in 2009, the Korean market became the number one source market once again. What do you think is contributing to the South Koreans? The South Koreans coming back into the country in such force?
Well, for one, the Koreans are starting to travel again overseas after the economic crisis that hit most other destinations in Asia. Clearly, one of the biggest advantages of the Philippines is its proximity to Korea. We also believe that our resort and beach attractions are among the best in the region, and this has been a very strong magnet for Koreans to come to the Philippines. So they visit Bohol, they visit Cebu, Boracay, and Palawan, which are top destinations. Many of the Koreans also come for the ESL, or English as Second Language courses, and we feel that we're quite competitive in offering ESL courses to the Korean market. So these are some of the reasons I think that contributed to the spike or the drastic increase in Korean arrivals into the Philippines.
Is this something you're actively investing in terms of the education? For example, you mentioned English as a second language, other education courses as well, because obviously within the Asia-Pacific region, a lot of people travel to Australia, they travel all the way back to the UK, to Americas, for an education as well. Is this something that you're actively investing in as a government?
Certainly. This is part of our product development efforts. We realize that it's very important to develop the product and customize it according to the requirements of the market. So in the case of English as second language courses, we are confident that we can position the Philippines as a strong destination to the Korean market. And this is just one example of the wide range of product development programs that we've lined up. Apart from product development, we're also looking at intensifying our marketing and promotion. So we are in the Korean Travel Fair in June, we are in Busan Travel Fair in September. We organize roadshows and missions throughout the year. We do joint promotions with our Korean counterparts. So it's a whole package. And very, very important is that we would like to increase air access. So apart from the operations of the legacy carriers, we're opening our destinations to the budget carriers and low-cost carriers. And one of the newer players to come to the Philippines via Clark is Jin Air of Korea.
Right. How important are the low-cost carriers? Because obviously AirAsia is about to set up operations as well in the Philippines. Cebu Pacific is doing extremely well for the Philippines itself. How important are these low-cost carriers to tourism into the Philippines?
Well, essentially it provides value for money, and it provides the consumer with more choices. So, and we've seen how the LCCs have contributed to the growth of inbound arrivals to the Philippines.
Right. One way for people, for a government to actually increase the tourism is by sports and events. Using sports, using musical events, concerts, this, that, the other. What sort of sporting events are you looking to attract to come to the Philippines in order to attract more visitor arrivals in that way?
I think the best example of a big ticket sports tourism event is the Ironman Triathlon, which we had in Kamsur Water Sports Complex, CWC as we call it. This is in the Bicol region, just southeast of Manila, and we had thousands of foreign competitors who came over. So this is just one of the many sports tourism events that we would like to promote more of.
Right. And is this is an annual event that takes place?
Yes.
Right. And are there any other sports events that you're actually targeting? Because obviously with some of the big ticket items like football or some of the big, in terms of media, like the media coverage, you have rugby, you have the athletics, you have the all those sorts of things. Do you have anything in the pipeline at the moment?
Well, we have, there is the regular Southeast Asian Games, which is held every 2 years, and we last hosted it in 2005, so we won't get our turn until, you know, a few years from now. But what we're seeing now is that many of the regions in the Philippines are developing their own sporting events and sporting activities, and I think one of the better examples that we'll be seeing in the months to come is the Mount Apo Challenge. So there will be mountain climbing and trekking and mountain biking up and down Mount Apo.
Oh,
and I'll give you the brochure.
Will you be taking part?
Oh yes, it's our DOT Davao office that's spearheading it.
And you'll be taking part in the events themselves?
As a spectator.
I think that's very wise, very wise. When is this taking place?
I believe that's in April.
April, excellent, okay. And in terms of the other tourism facets, obviously medical tourism is very important at the moment. How are you trying to attract medical tourism, and in which countries are you targeting primarily for medical tourism to the Philippines?
Right now, the strongest market of the Philippines for medical tourism is the U.S. So many of them come for their executive checkup, for I'd say cosmetology type of tourism, you know, facials and eyebrows and eyelashes and all that. But you also get a number of medical tourists from the Middle East and some parts of Europe.
How do you compare the Philippines? How does the Philippines compare to some of your neighbors that are also trying very, very to target these in a very aggressive manner?
Well, I think our competitive advantage lies in our medical professionals, our doctors, who are considered among the best around the world. And I think it's in our nature, it's our character to take care of people. So this is a competitive edge that we have.
Right. Now, as we move forward, everything you're saying today sounds very positive. It sounds like the Philippine tourism is moving in the right direction. Which areas of the Philippines are you primarily targeting for tourism growth as we move forward this year and up until 2016-15?
Well, the major gateways will still be Manila and Cebu. But as Manila and Cebu grow, we will see more movements to the other secondary destinations. So already we're seeing movements to Bohol, Boracay, Palawan, Davao, Clark, Subic, Bicol, and up in Banaue.
A lot of people will have questions about safety. I've been to the Philippines many times. It is, of course, a safe destination, but there are certain areas where people do have concerns, especially maybe on religious grounds, where there are certain issues in terms of global politics and global tourism. Is it a safe place to visit, or should people take precautions in certain areas?
Well, there's a big difference between the perception and the actual situation. And the best way to judge for yourself is to actually visit the Philippines and see the actual situation. But we realize that the perception remains as a biggest challenge for us. And this is the reason that we are intensifying our PR and publicity campaign. We'd like to communicate the good news to the markets. And in the meantime, we would like to get more travel agents coming to the Philippines on familiarization tours. We'd like to get more of our partners from media coming to the Philippines so that they can see for themselves that it's a safe, secure, enjoyable destination.
Right. Now, for these travel agents, those watching around the world or listening to this, when will you be planning this? Can they contact you? How should they get involved in terms of they'd like to start promoting the Philippines again? How should those travel agents in Europe, the US, within Asia Pacific get involved with this?
Well, in terms of the schedule, we do it year round, from January all the way to December. There are two ways of doing it. They can get in touch with me, or they can get in touch with any of the overseas offices of the Department of Tourism. So if it's in Australia, we have an office in Sydney. If it's in Europe, we have offices in London and Frankfurt, in the US all over, in Asia all over.
To somebody, obviously, you know the Philippines very well. You've traveled there all the way around the Philippines. You've seen all the different benefits and what have you. To somebody that hasn't been to the Philippines, they have all the advertisements from Bali. Your budget is not quite as large as some of your neighbors. So how would you answer the question, how does it differ? Why should people come to the Philippines and not go to Indonesia or not go to Thailand? What makes the Philippines stand out?
I'd say that we are relatively new. We are relatively undiscovered. So if you want to avoid the huge throngs of tourists that you see in other destinations, then you come to the Philippines.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much today for your time, Mr. Bengzon.
Thank you,
sir. And I do hope the Philippines starts moving forward from this point.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.